I never really knew my father's side of the family, never liked the man, and never really cared. And my grandfather, this Sir Edmund Gladsbury, I don't even recall if I ever met the man. Although I didn't have to meet him to learn that he was both a recluse and a bit of a weirdo. The will made that perfectly clear, full of loopholes and special rules. But I must admit, I was surprised to hear my name in there, and even more so when I heard what he had left behind for me. The Grand Gladsbury Estate, one of the oldest houses in New England, was said to be mine on one special condition. The attorney didn't have the deed to the place in his possession, and I could see that even though he struggled to stay professional, the conditions of the will baffled him as well. It said, "If you are able to enter the heart of my house, it is yours, with all the riches it holds, but you must think and act like a true Gladsbury, not like your dim-witted cousins and nieces. Get to the heart or leave penniless." The will caused quite an uproar. The rest of my family, hungry as vultures, tried to explain that my grandfather was clearly not in his right mind when the will was written, but the attorney kept insisting that the will was valid and the challenge was up to me. So I took a trip down here for the weekend, only holding the solid brass key to the front halls. I wish I knew what this grand mansion had in store for me, and now that I am here, I suddenly understand how deep my grandfather's madness went.
You've made it this far. Well, a simpleton would as well. But at least I am relieved you made it to this point. I guess you and I should get a bit more acquainted, since you seem so desperate to push through. But let me reassure you, you have a long way ahead of you still. A thought occurred to me while I was rebuilding this house. This has always been the Gladsbury Manor. But as I was renovating and replacing, thought hit me. How many bricks would you say I could remove, and this would still be the fabled Gladsbury Manor? Surely the entity of the house would survive a brick or two being replaced. But what if it went further? The botanical gardens have been rebuilt from the ground up before, so no doubt that doesn't make the house lose its identity. You think it would remain the Gladsbury Manor to the very point when replaced the final brick with a new one? Or would it still be intact, even though everything was replaced? I trust you know I can't hear you. Me being dead and all, by the time you hear this recording. But I still want you to think about this. How much can we lose and still be ourselves? If it applies to houses, surely it applies to us as well. Think about it. I have other things to attend to while you worm yourself out of this next room.
Thank you. Thank you.
both body waged a fight. But body won, it walks upright. Then he struggled with the heart. Innocence and peace depart. Then he struggled with the mind. His proud heart he left behind. Now his wars with God begin. At stroke of midnight, God shall win. It is said that in ancient China, the emperor owned time. He could decide how long a day was, how long an hour, when the sun would set or rise. Sadly, it was only a myth made to solidify his power. But think closely about it. As you would have learned by now, no matter what challenges you face, time is always your greatest enemy. Now, time travel is sadly not a feasible method for getting around this, and neither is stopping time. But there is one way to defeat this adversary. It just takes patience and commitment. I wonder if you have the kind of commitment that it would take. Are you compatible? If this recording ends up in flames, then I suppose I was wrong. But if you make it, maybe there is hope for you still.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, you have reached the end of your journey. And now, only one choice stands between you and your future. One of these levers will disable the explosives. And you can take this mansion as your own. The others, well, let's just say there won't be much left if you touch either one of them. But mansion and money, these are but simple and trivial trinkets. What I offer you is something so much more. The closest anyone has ever come to immortality. I offer you me. Everything I know, every science I have mastered, this is your true inheritance. And by making it up to this point, you have shown that your mind is compatible. Think about it. You will still be you, but with over 70 years of knowledge added to your mind. That which would take a lifetime to learn and to master can be yours before the sun sets. This was my last invention, hidden from the world. This is my ultimate secret, and a great deal has been sacrificed to assemble it. Yes, all my inventions, all my knowledge, every unknown, even things about your own family that you were unaware of, can all be yours. It will feel like a dream and hurt you no more than a night on the town. Surely you can handle that. Everything is set. Step inside the machine. Gain my wisdom, and the first thing you'll find out is which lever is the safe one. Or you can leave and become just like your father, an ungrateful brat who never dared to take a chance, who never dared to rise above his own pathetic existence. Use the machine. Gain the intelligence of one who has spent every minute of his life learning. And once your grandchildren are old enough, you can bestow the same privilege upon them, making sure our bloodline will never end. Ah, for those who are believers, this would be nothing short of a miracle. I don't even think I can describe this feeling. My body being carried away, yet my thoughts still raging, and the ability to breathe again returning. I confess to you that planting the explosives was a very great risk to take. But this is divine. Don't worry. You will still be you, and I will still be me. Or at least, that's how I think this will turn out. But one thing is absolutely certain. From this moment on, whatever you spend your days doing before is in the past. Now, the Gladsbury name will live forever.